Good morning, students. Let's start today's lesson with chapter number 3, Interior of the Earth. In previous class, we have read about the structure of the Earth interior. The sources which provide us knowledge about interior of the Earth are classified into two groups: indirect sources and direct sources. So, these sources are density, temperature, pressure, earthquake waves. First point, density. According to Newton's laws of gravity, Earth's density as a whole is 5.5 gram per cc. The sedimentary rocks on the surface of the Earth have an average density of 2.7 gram per cc. Beneath the sedimentary rocks, there are igneous rocks with average density varying from 3.0 to 3.5 gram per cc. So, the density inside the Earth must be much higher. Core of the Earth has a density of 11 to 12 gram per cc. It may rise to 13 to 14 gram per cc at the center of the Earth. The increase in density with the increase in depth is due to pressure of the upper layers, and the core itself is made up of heavy materials like nickel and iron, which have high density. Okay, come to the next point, that is temperature. There is a gradual increase in temperature with the increase in depth inside the Earth. The volcanic eruptions and hot spring further confirm this fact. The rate of increase of temperature is 12 degrees Celsius per kilometer at a depth of 100 kilometer, and it is 2 degrees Celsius per kilometer in the next 300 kilometer, and 1 degree Celsius per kilometer below it. Okay, look at the diagram. Pressure. Like density and temperature, pressure also increases with the increase in depth inside the Earth. This may be due to the overlying layers or the presence of heavier materials at the core of the Earth. Earthquake waves. The science of earthquake is known as seismology, and the evidences based on earthquake waves are known as seismological evidences. Seismic waves. Mainly two types of seismic waves are there: body waves and surface waves. Body waves divided into two parts, P wave and S wave. P wave. These are also known as primary waves. They are longitudinal waves like sound waves. Average velocity is 8 km per second, which is higher than any other waves. P waves can travel through all the mediums, including solids, liquids and gases. So, this is the characteristics of P waves. Next, S waves. These are known as secondary waves. Average velocity is 4 km per second. They can travel through solids only and disappear in liquids. This is the characteristics of S waves. Surface wave. They travel along the surface of the Earth. That's why it's called surface waves. These are also known as long waves. L waves means long waves, can travel through all the mediums, liquid, solids and gases, but their average velocity is just 3 km per second. Surface waves are of two types. One type consists of Rayleigh waves, and the second type of surface waves is the love with. Next point, behavior of the earthquake waves. Look at the diagram. All the three PS and L waves are recorded near the focus of the earthquake. Look at the point, focus written here. They follow a curved path in the interior of the earth, which proves that the density increases inside the earth. P and S waves are recorded along the surface up to a distance of 11,000 km from the focus of the earthquake. Their velocity also increases with the increase in depth. But this process continues only up to a depth of 2900 km. Beyond this depth, S waves disappear and P waves travel with reduced velocity. Why S waves disappear? Because they can travel through solids only and disappear in liquids. This process shows that the core of the earth behaves like liquids and mantle up to a depth of 2900 km behaves like solids. On reaching the core, S waves disappear and P waves are diffracted, as a result of which there are no waves for a distance of 5000 km beyond the 11000 km mark. This area is known as shadow zone. Look at the black shed area. Normally, shadow zone is found between 103 degree to 143 degree distance from the focus of the earthquake. So, this diagram shows the behavior of different types of earthquake waves. There is a change in the course and velocity of the waves on crossing the boundaries of different zones inside the earth. And these are the sources which provide us the knowledge about interior of the earth. Okay.